Hey guys, I'm here with Ray Santiago, star of the new show Ash vs. the Evil Dead. How are you doing today?
I'm good, man. I'm living my life.
Nice, nice. Or let's just jump right into your new show.
Okay, let's do it.
I saw a preview for it. Pretty funny.
Pretty scary.
Yes. Can you tell us more about it? And you play Pablo too.
Yeah.
And can you tell us more about your character and the
show?
Yeah,
for sure. Okay, so the show is it's a half-hour sitcom format of a cult classic comedic horror. So it's a throwback to the old-school horror genre where you would really laugh at things. And we're following Ash, the character from The Evil Dead. And this time, Ash has a bunch of sidekicks, and he's bringing us along for the ride. And so we're trying to help him defeat evil. And I play Pablo. Pablo is this guy who is Ash's idealistic main homie, and they both work at the same store. And you know, Pablo's from Honduras, and he's living in this country trying to sort of, you know, not let anybody know where he's from, because he doesn't want to be sent back. And as a kid, Pablo was told that, you know, there's evil lurking in the world, like most Latino families tell their kids.
Yeah.
That there's monsters out there, so they better behave. And he didn't believe in the evil force, and now he comes into contact with it, and he believes that his best friend Ash is the one to take them down. So together with a couple of other people, they try to save the world from the evil force.
Yeah, and Bruce Campbell is hilarious. How can you keep a straight face with some of the lines he says in the show?
You just learn to listen. You just learn to, like, you know, watch and let the master do his thing. Because, you know, what ends up happening is he'll have the line, and then they'll cut to, like, our faces.
Yeah.
So it kind of works perfectly because he sets it up, and then you laugh off of our reactions.
Yeah. So how is it with, there's a lot of blood. How is it filming with all that splattering all over you all the time?
I mean, blood is my thing now.
Yeah.
I'm really into it. Originally, you know, when I auditioned for Sam Raimi, the executive producer and director, I said that I wanted to be covered in as much blood as possible, and I wanted to run through the wilderness in New Zealand completely naked, being chased by deadites. And I think that we definitely check off a lot of those things on our show this season. Look, it comes with the territory, you know. As a kid, I was a huge fan of horror films, and I wanted to be the person being chased by the monster.
Yeah.
And I also wanted to be the person, you know, saving people from the monster.
Yeah.
So I get to be the first Latino sidekick on a horror genre show.
Uh-huh.
And the price that I have to pay is, you know, I get to be covered in blood every day.
How fun.
Yeah.
So how does this show differentiate from any other, like, zombie show there is out there?
That's a good question. So I feel like our show doesn't take itself too seriously.
Mm-hmm.
And like I said, it's a throwback to cult classic comedic horror. It's a half hour single camera format.
Mm-hmm.
So it's basically like a horror sitcom, and there's nothing else out there like it. We have, like, stunts, and we have lots of comedy, and we have lots of blood. And so you're going to basically laugh at the horror and the things that are happening on the show, whereas I feel like other shows are, you know, sort of straight up scary and dramatic, and ours sort of gives you a little bit of everything. And and it's also coming from a genre that was created by, you know, Sam Raimi, and it has an amazing following. So I think we wanted to make something that has a sense of nostalgia to the films, but also something new and fresh that the new generation could enjoy.
Yeah.
So we wanted to keep people, you know, so scared that they're on the edge of their seats, but then we throw them off the seat because they're laughing so hard.
Yeah, that's what I found myself doing watching the first episode. I'm like,
so you watched it?
Yes.
What did you think?
For me personally, like, I don't usually watch scary movies or anything like that, because blood, I'm just like, the whole time I was like, when those things are, I was like,
yeah.
Like, what is going on? But then I start laughing because your guys' dialogue is so funny. So I really like it.
Yeah, and that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to make people get scared, because there are some really scary scenes, like that scene with Jill, the cop. And then we make you laugh. So, I mean, and it's quick, you know, it's short.
Yeah.
It's, you know, half hour.
Mm-hmm. I like it. So what would be your game plan during a zombie apocalypse?
Well, I would say that I'm a really good runner. So I know how to run from bad situations. But I also grew up in the South Bronx. So, right. You know, I grew up dodging bullets and blades in New York City. And now
zombies
I just...
Like
zombies are a little different. But, you know, there are some zombies on our shows that have some knives and some guns that are coming at us.
Yeah.
But I would say that... You know, having grown up in New York City, that a lot of my friends were always surprised because, you know, I'm little and I seem like, you know, like I'm not going to really fight back.
Yeah.
But anytime I'm in a situation where I need to step it up, the Puerto Rican from the South Bronx comes out and fights back. So you just have to throw me in a situation and I'll figure it out. We'll be safe. Don't worry. I got your back.
Good. Yeah. I feel safe. Whatever happens, I'm going to go with Ray.
Yeah.
Okay. So... I have another question for you.
Yeah.
If you could take a bite out of any celebrity, who would it be and why?
If I could take a bite out of any celebrity and who would it be and why? I guess the first person that popped into my head was Angelina Jolie.
Oh. Good choice.
I don't know. I think she's just, I just, you said bite celebrity, and I saw like her juicy lips. So, I would.
Good choice. I'm sure a lot of guys would pick that.
But now that I'm thinking about it, I'm like, ooh, I'd take a bite out of Nicki Minaj because she seems really juicy.
Oh,
so, I'm okay with
answer,
that. And then as I keep thinking about it, I'm like, well, what does the bite mean?
Yeah, it's like, I have a list now
like,
for
am
the,
I eating
what,
them?
What do I want to take
am
a bite?
Am I like a zombie? Like, like, am I like a vampire?
Yeah.
I mean, you know, there's so many different reasons why I would want to bite so many different celebrities. You have to be specific with that. You can't just say who and why.
I know. Okay, so that was a great answer. So we know you as Jorge in Meet the Fockers.
Yeah.
Do you still get recognized as that character often?
It's crazy. Weekly people recognize me from Jorge, as Jorge, and now you know people are starting to sort of come at me with oh hey Pablo, like I was at the flea market this weekend in Pasadena, and two fans were like, oh my God, are you Pablo? Like your hair, like nobody has hair like that. Are you Pablo? And I was like, yeah, I'm Pablo. And so we took a selfie. So I feel like it's gonna change, but yeah, no, it's great because I get this opportunity to play these sort of you know. Pop cultural iconic characters that sort of stay relevant for a while because of the project. And and I like it, you know, because I think both Pablo and Jorge are sort of you know, positive Latino portrayals of characters.
Mm-hmm.
And that's something that, you know, I struggle with because I've been doing this for over a decade and I've told the story of many gangbangers and drug dealers. And, you know, I don't think there's anything wrong with that, but I like to sort of shed a little bit light onto other characters.
Mm-hmm.
And I think both Pablo and Jorge do that in a great way because they make you smile.
Yeah. We love those characters.
Yeah.
So can you give me your best Zoolander face? We'll both do it. Are you still in contact with Ben Stiller?
Occasionally.
Yeah.
Occasionally. I talk more to Dustin.
Cool.
Yeah, more than anybody else. He was like the grandpa that sort of took me under his wing when we were on set. Yeah. He showed me to his like gymnasium trailer and was whenever you want to work out, you can like work out here. And he was like really healthy and ate a lot of strawberries.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That's interesting. Did you actually work out with him though?
I never actually worked out in the trailer with him, but I would go when he wasn't there. Yeah, I learned a lot from all those people. I mean, it was it was an amazing opportunity because I hit so hard, you know, coming into a project with such strong hitters, such A-listers, and trying to learn from all of them. And I kind of try to do the same thing right now because, you know, on our show we have Xena, we have Lucy Lawless, and we have Bruce Campbell, who is this, you know, legendary, iconic, you know, actor and character and has had such longevity in his career. Mm-hmm. And so I just, you know, try to follow the leader and learn from the people around me because, you know, the people who have been around for a while are doing something, right? So I just try to absorb as much as I can.
Yeah. And so we're going to play a little game, Fact and Fiction.
Okay.
So I'm going to read some statements about that I looked up about you.
I bet you most of them are fiction.
Really? Okay, we'll see. All right, first one, Fact or Fiction.
Yeah.
You sang at a vegetarian convention.
Okay, I'm going to have to ask you because you have to play the game too. Do you think that's Fact or Fiction? Come on.
Fiction. True. I don't
know. What, is that your final answer? I am a singer.
Really?
It's fiction.
Really?
It's fiction.
Why is it on your IMDb?
Because this director that I used to that I worked on a movie with thought it would be really cool to put all these different things on my IMDb profile, and so everyone always asks me random things. What's your next one? Let's see if it's fact or
okay.
fiction.
Okay. You like to salsa dance.
What do you think, fact or fiction?
I'm gonna say fact.
Fiction.
Fiction. Do you have like a favorite dance move you have though on the dance floor?
The nene.
The nene. Can you do the whip and nene?
Can you do the whip and nene?
Yeah, I could.
Okay, I'd rather see you do it than me.
But then I'd rather you do it with me. But do you know how to do
it? Do I know how to do the nene? Yeah, but I don't do it really well. I don't do it.
Whip.
Okay.
And then you nene. It's kind of hard with this
No,
maybe
I just...
Maybe we'll just pass on that because we have a mic in our hand. I don't know.
It's okay. I want to know what else. Are we still playing this fact
yes,
or fiction?
Yes, we are.
Okay.
Okay. Fact or fiction. Uh-huh. You auditioned for Robert De Niro for Meet the Fockers.
Okay, what do you think, fact or fiction?
Fact.
Yes!
Yeah, How was that?
It was... You know, when you're like 19 years old and you walk into a room... You own the room no matter what because you're 19 and you have nothing to lose and you have everything to gain. If you put me in a room with Robert De Niro right now, I'd probably freeze up because I'm this, you know, self-conscious, like, 31-year-old who's just, like, cares too much about what people think. But it's just so funny to see how when you're younger, you can sort of, you can be more powerful. And that's why Pablo is good for Ash because I got that younger juice to keep everybody alive.
Yeah.
Are we still playing fact or fiction?
One more.
Okay.
You love to cook.
What do you think?
Fact?
Yeah, fact.
Yes. Yeah. Okay, what is your specialty dish?
Two things. I love to cook breakfast. I cook a mean scramble with sriracha and spinach and turkey and onions. And then I'm Puerto Rican. I like to cook flan. Like, that's what my mom taught me how to make, a flan. So every time I go to somebody's house, like, for dinner, I'll cook a flan. And it usually goes well unless they're lactose intolerant. And I mean, you can't have it. You can't have flan.
All right, so the holidays are coming up. Are you doing anything special for Thanksgiving?
I'm jumping from house to house. I have a couple of friends that are different houses that are cooking. And so I'm just going to jump from place to place. And we... We play this game called Werewolf. I'm a big game night kind of guy.
Yeah.
I'm actually supposed to either go to this event tonight or go to a game night in Hollywood with my friends. And I feel like I want to go to the game night. We play like this game called Werewolf, which is like Mafia.
Oh, yeah. I love Mafia.
And then we play Celebrity and Charades. So, So I'm a game night type of guy. I'd much rather be at home drinking some wine and eating dark chocolate and playing a game night with my homies.
That sounds.
So that's probably what I'll be doing on Thanksgiving. Yeah.
Awesome. Thank you so much for chatting with us.
Oh, thank you for having me.
Don't forget to catch Ray on Ash vs. Evil Dead on Stars at 9 p.m. on Saturdays, right?
Yeah. Ash vs. Evil Dead, 9 p.m. Stars, Saturdays.
Yes. Bye, guys.
Thanks. Hey, I'm Ray Santiago, and you're watching Entertainment Scoop.